I want to talk about everyone's favorite topic, happiness. How to achieve happiness. My name is Ilan Ferdman. I'm a speaker, mentor, and coach. I run a company called Satori Prime with my brother, Guy. And happiness is on everyone's mind. You've probably watched hundreds, if not thousands of videos on trying to figure out how to bring more happiness, more joy, more love into your life. So let's talk about happiness here for a second. And I'm gonna say this, and it might rub you the wrong way, but happiness is nothing more than a chemical reaction. You don't even have a measure of happiness. Happiness is simply a chemical reaction that happens in your brain, and it breaks down pretty simply to this. You have expectations in your life. You have expectations on what relationships look like, what your bank account should look like, what your body should look like, etc. The level to which that expectation is either met, exceeded, or unmet below is the level of happiness. If you have an expectation and you've met that expectation, you are happy. If you've surpassed that expectation, you are really happy. Anywhere below that expectation being met, here, upset. Here, more upset. Here, tragedy. Really, what's happening is this. We go through life with expectations about everything. How people should respond, how we should act, what our bank account, what car, how people are, etc. All of this is very programmed in at a very animal level, and we're gonna talk about that in just 1 second. But really what there is to get at this moment is this. Your lack of happiness is simply a chemical reaction. When expectations are met, serotonin is fired, dopamine is fired in your body, you are ecstatic. When those things are not met, cortisol goes into your system and that creates a threat response. So first thing to understand is there's nothing wrong with you. Happiness is not something you can search for in videos or anything like that. There's just a physiological response happening in your body. An expectation is met, there's an immediate cortisol flush which says, holy crap, pay attention, and you have a physical threat response that gets triggered in your body. Now this happens for a very simple reason, and let's just break it down into the animal kingdom. This response is constantly comparing and contrasting, we do this all the time as humans, to everyone around us. Now if you think as human beings as animals, right, then think of, for example, apes or lions or things like that, right? We're constantly trying to size up the competition. Is this someone that I can beat? Or is this someone that I should walk away from because there's a good chance that I'm gonna lose? And that same animal mentality is why we are constantly comparing and contrasting ourselves to everything we see in media, to our friends, to people we read about, and we're constantly saying, well, I'm not like them, or I don't have what they have, and blah, blah, blah. And instantly in that moment, we start to feel that physical threat response. It's a chemical reaction. How does this help? It helps in this. Awareness is everything in life. The things that we have awareness over, we now have choice about. You have mostly gone through life with I'm not happy, or I'm depressed, or I'm this, or I have anxiety. All of which is just physical chemical reaction. So the next time you're in that state, you can actually stop and notice that, oh, there's a physical chemical reaction happening in my system right now. It's not that there's something wrong with me, which is where our mind likes to go. It's not that there's immediately something that I have to run and fix. What we also know, that these physical chemical reactions erupt and then subside. And when they subside, you feel back to normal. Yes, you might get hijacked for a minute or two, but it's the fighting the hijacking that actually makes you feel more anxious, more stressed, more depressed. If the next time you got really upset, you actually could stop and realize, wow, there's a chemical reaction. I have a physical threat response that's happening inside of me. And if I just sat here and did nothing, I would actually allow for this response to diminish. Instead of running around like a chicken with my head cut off, trying to fix it in some way, trying to make it go away in some way, I could actually just let it be, let it process through, and then once I'm out of that chemical reaction wave, then I get to choose what would be a great logical step for me to do next. So again, next time, just bring a little bit more awareness to that and see how it can completely change your life. I really hope this helped. If it did, and you know someone else that this could help, please share this video. And if you enjoyed it, like it. And if you want more content like this, make sure you subscribe to our channel because we're releasing content like this quite often, almost every single week. So again, I hope you enjoyed it. And until we see each other again, have an amazing day.